Hey guys, welcome to the 11th episode of Static Timing Analysis. Today onwards, we will do hands-on static timing analysis using the OpenTimer STA tool. In VLSI, when you learn any software hands-on, you have to stack the corresponding theories in back of your mind. In last 10 episodes, we have covered all the theories and some amount of SEA commands. So now we are ready to play with the STA tool on VLSI test cases. Stay tuned till the end of this episode for hands-on knowledge using OpenTimer STA tool.
Hey guys, welcome back. We are in our computer now, and this is the menu for today's episode. First, we'll do the cloning of OpenTimer test case into our local directory through of various files inside the test case. OpenTimer alias creation for easy use. Hands-on design loading in OpenTimer. Hands-on report timing command for various of its switches like min, max, rise, fall. Then hands-on example of report FEP, report TNS, report WNS, etc. Then we'll do the hands-on on report slack command for its various switches like min, max, rise, fall, etc. So this is a very consolidated menu for today. So without any further delay, let's begin the hands-on practice using the OpenTimer STA tool. So folks, as we have discussed that we will clone the OpenTimer test cases from its GitHub link local to our directory. So let's first go to the OpenTimer GitHub URL. So I'm typing in Google. So OpenTimer STA. Once I click here, I get the first link as the OpenTimer URL. Now this URL I am providing in the description. You also can pick it up from the description. So here, once you open right, you can see there is a folder called example. This is clickable. So once we click it, we go up to the subdirectory here, you can see. So we need this particular directory to go inside, and we'll start our hands-on practice using the simple test case. And once we click the simple subdirectory, right, we can see we have gone up to this much of depth. So we want to clone this simple test case and all of these files here in the test case into our local directory. So how we do that? So we go to our terminal, and I have created a directory here for OpenTimer test case in my hard drive. So there I am using ghclone. So the installation of the ghclone binary is also given in the description, so you can pick it up from there. It's very easy to use. So what we do here first we type ghclone, and then we give the URL. So URL is here, right here. We can use the Control A to select all, and then Control C to copy, and then we here and click our middle mouse button. So this is the command for copying the simple test case from this particular URL locally to our hard drive. So let me hit the enter. So it started cloning the simple test cases and all the files. It's showing it's done. So let me do a ls. So here I can see the folder simple that has been cloned into my local hard drive. Now this cloning term is very much specific to GitHub. It is similar to copy. The copy, the cp command that you use in your Linux system or Unix system. Since you are downloading from the GitHub repository into your local hard disk, we are using the term cloning, and hence the binary is also named as ghclone. One more thing I would like to tell you, that I have given all the description and the install instruction of OpenTimer and all the necessary dependencies even for the ghclone, everything in the description, so you can find it out there. So now let me go inside the directory. I hit the tab and I am here. Let me do a ls. ls. Okay. So here I can see there are a lot of files here. This is how the test case has been created by the OpenTimer team. So let me open one by one. So I am using my gvim alias to g, and hence I am using my alias. So you can see which g gives me the gvim. Okay, so I am using gvim here. Just I am opening the Verilog file. So you can see here, first we have the module here, the module name, and then we have set of inputs and outputs defined for this particular module, and we have all the nets, that is wire connection here, and here we have the instances. Now you are asking from where they are coming. If I go here and we go to OpenTimer, and there if we scroll down right, here you can see this is a simple test case, a timing report example on a sequential circuit design. The description is this. And the library is OSU free PDK 45 nanometer. If I hover my mouse pointer over it, you can see the link from where this PDK belongs to. It's a 45 nanometer PDK, and you can also go into the URL if you want to explore it. And we are using this simple test case. So now let's come back to here in the gvim. So all these cells are belonging to this 45 nanometer PDK. So from there we have got all these cells. Now let me close this particular file. Now let me open the next one, that is the SDC file. So here you can see the SDC file have been opened, and you can see that I have already in the SDC file episode, I have described what are the contents inside the SDC file and how these design constraints are written and what they mean. In case you have not watched the episode, please go ahead and see that episode. Here you can see that there is a create clock. Clock is created. Then we have specified the input delay. We have used max and min branches and rise and fall splits. And we have four ports, so we have used, and we have also used the clock. So we have used the delay and the time unit. We have time unit can be seen when we report all these units inside the OpenTimer shell. You can get the timing units there. And here also, now this is the delay. Now we have set all the transitions here. You can see all the transitions here has been set for the min max and as well as their rise and fall splits. So here are the ports and here are the clocks. Okay, so we have also put the load here, and output delay also specified. So all these design constraints have been specified in the SDC file. So you can learn more about in the episode where I have discussed about the SDC file. So we are done with this particular file, so let's close it. So next file is the lib file. So this is the timing lib file. Let me turn off the highlight. Here I have closed the highlighting, otherwise it is very tough to see. And you can see before going ahead or telling anything, I have also created episode on how to read and how to interpret the timing library for STA and what all the things you get there and what are their meanings. Please watch that episode in case you have not watched. So here is the timing library for that particular PDK. And if we see, here is a particular header section where all these threshold, PCT rise, PCT fall, all etc. and norm process, norm voltage, norm temperature and operating condition, that is PVT, is also defined here. PVT is defined. So you can see here all the LU table template are here, and then once we cross this section, then we have cell. And here if I just go, this is a cell end. Again in GVM I have used shift and percent for the matching curly braces. So again here there is another cell, and if I go down here we can see different pins are there and all the LUTs are there. So you can interpret this particular timing library. Now all these files will be going inside the OpenTimer shell once we invoke it and once we source it. Rest of the files are a couple of configuration files are there, that is internal and maybe specific to the OpenTimer. You can explore them by yourself. In case you have a question, you can put it down. Just one thing I would like to show you here. Here it's the timing file. Here there are some internal formats of OpenTimer by which the AT, RAT, slew, etc. and the clock is defined. All these things have been defined for this particular test case. And I think CPP file we will not talk about right now, because the CPP is for the API sections. And we are doing here very much simple analysis using the shell. At some later point, we may look into the CPP and explore that particular side. Right now, we will be focusing on the basic example. Now, here is the simple.conf. Conf is nothing but it gives a shortcut of all the commands that we use. Generally, here you can see all the commands. Sequentially, they have mentioned in the conf file. So basically, we can do it by hand once we turn on the shell. So now at this point, two things we are done. First, we have done the cloning of the test case. Second thing, we have made ourselves familiar with all of the files inside the test case, and also we know from which PDK all these cells have come. So here I would like to turn on the OpenTimer shell. Now there is a good point that OpenTimer, I have created the alias. So let me invoke the alias. So when I do the which OpenTimer in my shell, I can see that the OpenTimer command is alias to this. So when I grab the CSHRC file and the text I am grabbing is OpenTimer, what I get? The alias. So alias OpenTimer, and this is the thing here, the path of this, and how you set the path, all these things I have given in the description, so please check it out. This has also been told in the installation of OpenTimer, there also I have mentioned. This is for the CSH cell or TCSH cell. In case you are using the bash, this alias command will be changed. And I think you can find it once you Google it, how to do the alias in the bash. So we are done up to this point. Now let me clear the screen. We are now cleaned. Now, so here we are now. Let me hit the OpenTimer. So here I have typed the OpenTimer. Let me do the ls. Ls gives all the files here. So one good thing of this shell is that if you type right and if you hit tab, the command get completed. Let me show you how. So once I type read and then I hit the underscore, what I get? That all the commands I am getting. Okay, first I'll read the lib file. read cell lib, and then I give the cell lib name here. Okay, and the first thing is done. The next thing is that what we do is we read Verilog file. Read Verilog, and then we have the Verilog simple.b. We read the Verilog. Then we are using the read SDC. So I'm copying the commands from here and copying the file from here. Read timing. Okay. So read timing and then simple.timing. So I think all these files are done. Reading and internal loading of the files is done. Now let me do the report timing. Here, once I doing the report timing, right, I am not giving any of the arguments at the beginning. And let me see what happens. So what you can see that it has read the Verilog, then it has read the timing, and all this timing I have shown this file also, some few simple settings for the this tool, and then loaded the SDC and then the lib, all these things. And you can see the units are here, and finally here it is giving this particular output. Now we are getting only one output. If we want to get all the outputs, so here let me bring up the report command. First let me clear the screen and we go back to the beginning, and here let me invoke the report timing command, and here this is num underscore path, and I hit 10. So here we can see a huge number of violations are coming. You know the right that the max is for the setup violation and mean for the hold violation. If you can see here, it is mean violation and here is hold failing. I have already explained in the last episode, and here you can see again this is mean and it is hold failing. Now if I scroll down right, also there are more mean violation, means hold violation are there. There is also max, that is setup violation. So you can see here. Now if I want to just segregate the hold violations, let me clear the screen. Clear the screen here, and here my screen is clear again. Let me push the up arrow of my keyboard, and here the report timing commands come. And what I have to do, I have to do the max analysis for the hold violations only. So this will provide only the hold violations. So once I type in, right, you can see the hold violations, that is the max violations are reported. So here how to analyze this particular report, I have already explained in last episode. So please watch that episode to interpret this one. And you can see here it is also the max is coming. So here you can see there are the start point is f1 colon clk, and the final is out. So this is clock to out this path. So that is a basically rage to output path. So here you can see the difference lying in this particular column. So direction, that is fall, rise. Okay. So here this is the direction based on which the difference in the slack is coming. Okay. The slack is here -10.724 and here is 10.042. So the difference is in this particular column because of the path is same. F1 colon CLK to out, and here is also the same path is there. Variation of the rise and fall transition, say if we are considering this fall, then rise, and then finally we are having considering fall. So here you can see that combination is different, and because of this we are getting the particular difference in the slack. Now my question is, we have this, and then what if I want to segregate one level down, what I have to do? So let me clear the screen. We are again at the top, and here max, and then if I give the rise, okay, and I hit enter, so the rise split is displayed. And if I give the fall, the fall split is defined. You can see that here the two slacks are different for the rise and fall split. So this way we can further narrow down or do the filtering of hold violation or setup violation. In this case we are doing the max, that is setup violation. And now let me go for the hold violation. Okay, so let me clear the screen. I hit clear, the screen is clear. Now let me erase these things and give min. So here once I hit the min, what I see that there are a lot of 1, 2, 3, 4 hold violations are there. The fold hold violations are there here, and obviously these are the worst cases of violations. When we talk about, these are the pessimistic cases on which we are getting the violation. Now if I want to split the rise and fall category, right, what I do, let me clear. I have done the clear of this particular screen, and let me bring up that particular. Okay, now here we add a rise. So here once we do the rise, right, we can see that two categories of rise split here. For the hold violation, in the rise split we have two violations here. And if we give let me clear the screen again, and let me bring it. And in case of fall, we are getting how much? So again, two are there. Okay, so for the fall split also we have two violations. So you can compare these columns for one particular category, right, for the fall or rise split. Okay, fall, fall, rise, rise, fall, 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 rise, rise, fall, fall. Okay, and finally the fall. But in case both are similar, the directions are similar, right? And in case we had the rise, what we see here, if we see rise, rise, fall, fall, rise, rise, and rise, rise, fall, fall, rise, rise, so their transition directions also same. So these two are coming in the rise split and these two are coming in the fall split. So this way you can also see that different branching outs of the violations in cases when there is a rise transition, when there is a fall transition, right? During the entire series, during the theoretical explanation, during the timing lib chapter or episode, I have mentioned that there are various rise and fall conditions. So the rise and fall delay and slew, etc., may not be same, may be same. So there could be different cases. And here you can actually see where these particular things get impacted. So this is kind of a hands-on experience on using the open timer. So we are done for the report timing command for now. And for this test case, let's move on to the next examples. I'm clearing the screen here. And let me do the report. I hit report and I hit tab. Okay. So here so many report commands are there. So let me see what we are getting here. First, I am interested how much area will this design will cost. So I am saying So we can get the units, area units, get it from the dumping the units. I have already shown that in last episode. In the last slide, I have shown how to dump the units. And here the report area is 176. Now, I think the dump command is dump timer. Yes, the dump timer gives is the units. So here you can see all these units. Okay, whatever is there. So now let me clear the screen and I am hitting the report again. So there are so many report commands available here. What you can do, we can print different report commands here. Report area. So where is report TNS? We are reporting the TNS here. And if I hit the report WNS, it gives the WNS. Report FEP. Okay, so I have already given the description all these commands. I am not elaborating them, otherwise this will become much more lengthy. Want to make it very crisp, and that's why I am doing short and sweet things. So the report RAT. Okay, so you have to give the pin name, not now, we will do it later. So these things, and now let me do the report Slack. Report Slack. Also, we have to give the pin name. So let me do the report timing first to get the pins. So here simply we are getting one here. Let me put the report Slack here, and then dash pin. Here let me give about this pin. Okay, this particular pin I am picking up and giving it. Okay, so here the Slack is -22.2. So even now if we want to go further down in the max, mean or rise, fall, okay, we can go further. So if I give the max, so it will give the max. You can see the max here, and if we give the mean, we can get the mean Slack. Okay, so whatever we are getting the here, it's the mean Slack. So mean Slack means because we are having the analysis type mean and we are getting the Slack. So once I reported first, right, it gave the mean one. But in case you want to see the max, we can see that. Now let me add more switches. So for mean, if I want to give rise, for fall we have a different. So for rise one thing we have, for fall we one thing have. So this way we can go every pin by pin and get their Slack. So this way we can do the analysis. Now let me give some more example using this report Slack command. And here so pin, let me see what is coming in the output. So here, although we are seeing the path from input to F1:D, but if I give report Slack, it's not dependent upon this report, but that's why I became curious and I wanted to see what is coming in the output pin, out pin. So here we can see this. Now if I want to vary it, max is coming as 10, mean is coming as 20, and then we can go for rise 20, fall 20.7. So here we want to report the slack in each and every branches. So mean max analysis and then rise fall split. So we can do any type of combination and find out the slack of that particular pin. I think we are done with today's example, and in next week we will do some more experiments. We'll explore some more commands. So we are done for today. Thank you very much for viewing up to this point. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. In case you have some dislikes, put that as in comments. And bye for today.